welcome back to my channel. My name is Rachel and today I am going to give you guys a bedroom tour, which is so exciting. I haven't done one in this house before. If you guys don't know, I live in a share house with three of my best friends, which is so fun. And I thought I would give you a little tour of my bedroom. I don't absolutely love it, but I also don't know what else I would do to make it better. If you guys want to see my bedroom when I was living at my parents' house, which was like fully, completely decorated, 100% how I wanted it to be, I'll link that down below. So I've been living in this house for a year and a half now, and I just wanted to show you guys what my room looks like. I will be answering some like frequently asked questions at the end of this video, but I didn't want to fill up the intro with just speaking. So if you have any questions about where anything is from or why my room is a certain way, please watch till the end of the video and I'll probably explain it. But if I don't, feel free to leave it in the comments below and I'll try my best to answer your questions. But I think that's it. So let's get started. So we're currently standing outside my bedroom. I actually have these sliding doors. So I'll open these up. And this is my bedroom. So I'll do a little pan for you guys so you can see most of it, and then I'll go through everything a little bit more in depth. I guess we'll start over this side. So over here, firstly, I just have a little hook where I hang my keys and my bag, which is so easy because I can just grab it and go when I'm leaving the house. I also have this sign which says be kind. I honestly can't remember where I got this. I think it was like from eBay or something, and it was so cheap. It's like a ripoff of like an Urban Outfitters type of thing, but I love it. And then I have my beautiful palm. It is huge. I've had it for about 6 months and it's just starting to open its first leaf, which is so exciting. If you guys are new to my channel, I love plants. So you'll see a few of them in this room. It's just in a basket from Target. And then I also have my dirty clothes basket, which is from either Target or Kmart. I can't really remember. Most things are either from Target, Kmart, or IKEA. So everything's super affordable. Moving on to my bed. The actual frame is from IKEA. Then my throw blanket and also this like matching cushion are both from Kmart. And then the two cushions behind it are from Target, along with like my actual bedspread, which you can kind of see it has like a waffle pattern on it, which I really like. I also have my photo wall, which I love. So many people ask me where I printed these. I literally printed them at Kmart and I just got the white border and the square prints, so it makes it super easy. Then I have a TV, which I literally never ever use. It actually came with the house, so I didn't put it up here. I wish it wasn't up, but I don't want to take it down because it'll be so hard to put back up again, and since we're renting, it's just not worth it. Then moving along this side here, I have my bedside table, which again is from Kmart. My lamp is from Target, and then the two little decor pieces, so the vase and the little box, are both thrifted. And then I just have some dried baby's breath, which is my favorite flower. And then I have a little bin next to it, which is from Target, I'm pretty sure. Underneath my bed, I have a lot of storage actually. So in this one, I just keep like excess shoes. In this one, I keep pajamas. And in this one, I keep all of my swimwear. Moving on, I have this little white shelf, which is again from Kmart. I'm so sorry that you have to hear me say that 100 billion times, but I'm just trying to tell you guys where everything's from. So at the top I have a little wooden board from Kmart, a little propagation station which I thrifted, and it's just got a snow queen in it. This vase is thrifted, and this little frame is from Kmart, and I just hand wrote the little quote in it, which is a Bible verse. Then I have my beautiful golden pothos, which is trailing down my little bookcase, which I adore. This was one of my first ever plants. Next to that, I have a little basket box, which is the same as the one below it, just a little bit smaller. These ones came together in a set from Kmart, and I just keep junk in them, things that I don't really want people to see but I need, so like medication, hair ties, random stuff like that. And then on the next shelf down, I have another one which I keep like clutches and bags in, like little bags. And then I also have this little framed picture of me and my eggs. And then on the last shelf, I just have a bunch of books. Most of them I've read, some of them I haven't yet, but it's just easy to keep them all together. And then I have my two little decor pieces. This little elephant is from my parents, and this little angel is from my boyfriend's parents. And I just love having them sitting together. Moving on, I actually have a couch in this room. So this couch is from Fantastic Furniture, and I got it in a custom material. So you can literally pick any colored material that you want, which I really like. So I got this like dark gray color, and it's kind of like speckled, if you can see, with like white in it. Then on top of that, I just have a throw blanket. It's not really a blanket, it's a Turkish towel. Don't know where it's from because it was a gift, but both of the cushions I have are from Kmart. Wow, I honestly am just a walking sponsorship for Kmart at this point. And then next to that, I have a little table, which is actually the same as my bedside table, but I've just got it over here. Then I've got this little thing on top of it, which I thrifted, and the pot is from Bunnings, if you're wondering. I love this plant. If you have like a white themed room, it's so perfect because it has the greenery. but then it also has the white stripes on the edging, so it's beautiful. That moves us into my mirror. This is a little freestanding mirror from Kmart. I think it was around $30 or $40, which is so cheap for a full length mirror. It is like fairly small, but like perfect for me. And then behind it, I just have a little hat hanging from Cotton On because I just had a hook there and it was easy to keep it there. Behind it, I store a bunch of random stuff like my hairstyling tools and my hairbrush and like some wrapping paper. It's super random, but it's just a really good place to hide it all away. Now we're actually back to the doorway where I started from, but I have one last thing to show you. If you close the doors, I actually have all of my Polaroids on the back of them, which is so cute. I love my Polaroid wall. One of my goals was to finish it by the end of the year, so we'll have to wait and see if I do. But I haven't got a super long way to go, but this is like 3 years worth of Polaroids, so I think there's about 200 up there at the moment, but I love all of my Polaroids. But that is my room. I've showed you everything pretty much, I think at least. Hopefully I haven't forgotten anything. But that is my bedroom. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing it. But before I end this video, I want to answer some frequently asked questions about my room because some things are a little bit confusing. So the main question that I get about my bedroom is, why did I put my bed against my TV? Because it kind of just means I can't watch it. And the reason for that is because this room that I'm in is actually technically not a bedroom. So I live in a 4-bedroom house with 3 of my friends, and this is actually like a media room or like a second lounge room, if that makes sense. At least that's how it was advertised when we found this place online. But I actually pay a little bit more rent to have 2 rooms in this house. So I have this room as well as one of the actual like bedrooms because I do YouTube and it's really nice to have like a filming space / an office space. So the other room that I have is actually a lot smaller than this one, which is why I liked having it as an office because all I have in there is like my clothes and my YouTube stuff and my desk. So that also answers another frequently asked question is, where are all my clothes? I don't have a wardrobe, I don't have dresses, and that's because all of my clothes, apart from my like pajamas and my like bikinis and stuff, is all in my other room at the other end of the house. If you watch my vlogs, it'll probably make a little bit more sense. But yes, I have 2 bedrooms technically, and this is technically not a bedroom. And the reason why I don't use the TV that I have is because I literally don't watch TV. I hardly watch movies, I hardly watch Netflix, so there's just no point for me to try and make my room fit around a way to watch the TV if I don't ever use it. And like I mentioned in the video, it's just not worth taking it down because it's gonna be so much effort to put it back up again, and I would have nowhere to store it. But I think that answers all of the most like frequently asked questions. If you guys want to know where anything is from that I forgot to mention, or if you have any other questions, please let me know. I'd be happy to answer them in the comments below. But other than that, I hope you enjoyed this room tour. Maybe it gave you some inspiration for your bedroom. And make sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Otherwise, I'll see you guys in my next video very soon. Goodbye.